Himanta, my name is Khurshid.
Hello, very nice to have you here.
Thank you. I'm from Uncle K Live TV and Radio. What we are trying to do here is interview all the companies who are helping Dubai grow with their products, with their taste, and keeping the philosophy of the government of Dubai that they want to give a chance. It's a free city.
Yes.
Anybody can bring their products.
Yes.
And the market decides who fails, who
succeeds. Yes.
So you have a chance to put your product and, I mean, with the quality and all, you have to raise your own bar and, you know, cross the benchmark which they have.
Yes.
So the consumers decide from the shelves of the supermarkets which product they will.
Right. Okay.
So you remember the old tradition that the tea, Ceylon tea, has its own quality. We agree to that.
Yes.
But everybody will not drink it unless you innovate and add some new
things. Exactly. Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
Even Lipton, if you see, Lipton was the biggest, is the biggest supplier of tea.
Mm-hmm.
But they keep on changing their taste, adding new things because people get bored with the old things. So these are the things I will be asking you. Are you still packing the same Ceylon? Sorry, I'm using the old name.
No, it's okay. It's more
Sri Lankan long grain, or I mean, what are the technical words you use for that?
Yeah.
I remember some tea. It used to be very, very long, and it would become like a green tea. It was black tea,
yeah,
but green.
Yeah. That is what is popular in Arab world. Okay. Long leaf tea.
And mostly, even in Lipton and other blends, they use, I think, 10% of Sri Lankan tea, and rest, to give the color, they use some other.
Yeah.
So you can tell me something technical about
that. Yes. Well, when you talk about our company, that is Basilur Tea, it's all about innovations.
Okay.
So you just gave me a very, very good start to talk about my company, because when we created this brand, not very long time ago, just 7 years into our operation, we created this brand with the pure intention of giving consumers something new, something unique. Because we knew that we had to fight with big companies in the world, including companies like Lipton. But we were not afraid, because we wanted to give something really new in terms of both packaging and in terms of tea quality. So the Basilur brand was created with that intention. So as you could see, we have over 450 different products in our range, which are all our innovations. So we, when you talk about the design, the packaging, just shape, everything, those are our own designs and shapes.
Sorry, it's going over my head. 450 brand flavors, just tea?
Just tea, just
so
tea.
So what is so, I mean, how?
That's the thing. So that's what we are trying to, you know, give people. Because previously with big brands, people were, you know, just simply able to drink just couple of grades or couple of standards or couple of different types of leaf teas, just black tea or green tea. And in very ordinary, normal packaging. So what we did was, we changed that, I would say, a 5,000-year-old beverage. We like sort of reinvented the tea gifting culture by introducing so much of gift products.
Okay.
So Basilur is mostly about the gifting, gift products.
Now you're getting that point I never had in mind. Yeah, that's a beautiful idea.
Yeah, so if you look at
present it to some other
exactly.
people.
Exactly. Yeah, so what you get good. Inside this packaging is a very good quality tea, but at the same time, as you could see, it's beautiful packaging as well.
Yeah.
So you can easily use the commodity tea to give it as a present to your loved ones. And for every mood, like
and a practical gift.
In a practical gift, when somebody would you know, enjoy.
Yeah.
So whether it's Christmas or whether it's Mother's Day, Father's Day, or Women's Day, we all have products for that.
Very, very, very. I mean, to the point, because every time they are sipping the tea, they'll remember you who gave
exactly,
us that.
Exactly. And we are a company which keep on innovating and introducing new products as well.
Okay.
So that's why after 7 years, we now have over 450 products. And we are still innovating, we are still keep on giving new products. So the whole idea of this particular company is to give people a new experience when they buy our products. It's not just a pack of tea that they would buy. So it's very high quality, 100% Ceylon tea. Of course, we have a couple of very specialty teas from like Darjeeling from India and some specialty teas from Milk Oolong from China. But 99% of our teas are from Ceylon or from Sri Lanka. And packed right where it is grown, we have our own factories and facilities, which are all ISO 22000 certified. So we can give a very fresh product to the consumers, but more than that, we are giving a tea product which is giftable.
That's right.
something very new.
Correct. Samantha, you have really increased my knowledge about this. At my age, I didn't want to go leave this world without knowing more about this. It all adds up.
Yes.
Okay. True. Now, one question only. I have seen many in my life, many companies, they had a very good product, good manufacturing, good packing, mm-hmm. but distribution, they failed in that, so they could not reach the market. Mm-hmm. Are you doing your own distribution, or do you have some distributors, or
no.
some, you know, people who are importers?
Yes, I understand. Our brand is now sold in 65 countries
okay.
around the globe,
okay.
from east to west. And in all those countries, we use importers and distributors from that destination, from that country. So we are not directly involved in the distribution as such. But we are, to date, we are very successful in using that method. And we are very happy that we have a very good partners in all over the world. They are dedicated and they are, you know, they dedicate everything to the brand. And they do a very good job. So we are pretty happy with their performances so far today.
So you are here as a backup and a boost to their business.
Well, certainly, you know, Gulfood is, this is not the first time that we are coming to this exhibition. We have been here a couple of times before.
Okay, okay.
And we participate about 18 exhibitions around the globe every year. So Gulfood is also like many other European exhibitions like Sial or Anuga. This is a good meeting point and these are like hub. Dubai is a hub for many things, for trading and activities. So here we treat not only for this Middle East market or for Dubai. Here we are to meet people from other countries as well, because a lot of people from other countries also
make new
visit.
Contacts.
Yes, they come here to meet people. They come here to find good products, new products. So we have found a lot of customers from the previous exhibition. So that's why we are here. And also to give an opportunity for the people in Dubai and in Middle East a chance to feel our products, to see our products themselves, come and talk to us. So it's different ideas behind it.
Himanta, it's very interesting what you're talking, but I had another question because of the restraint in time.
Please.
I don't know the policies of your country, your government. I've seen the successful products exporters, the countries which are good in export, they have very good laws and regulations of cooperatives helping boost the exporting quality. I mean, they give all the help they can for
yes.
the exporters.
Yes.
Is this the same in your country? Are you having a cooperative or export zone or export ministry of these type of things? How do you manage it?
Yes, we do have a Sri Lanka, we call it Sri Lanka Tea Board,
okay.
Which governs and controls each and every kilogram of tea exported out of Sri Lanka. They control the qualities, they control the standards, they check each and everything. And then also probably you would have seen the Lion logo, which has been introduced by the Sri Lanka Tea Board for products which carries 100% Ceylon tea and packed in Sri Lanka.
In other words, it's approved by the government.
It's approved by the government. It's a logo which is given to exporters, packed in Sri Lanka and uses 100% Ceylon tea and of very high quality teas. So likewise, yes, they do not only control, they support us. They even go to the level of like farmers controlling and helping them to grow good tea and to maintain the good quality production at the tea factories. And also they come to us as the exporters. And also there are a couple of incentive schemes and generic promotions that are being carried out by the government.
And your embassies are also helping in these.
Certainly. In many countries where we have embassies, there's always an attachee to the tea board.
Commercial attachee.
And also sometimes, for example, in Dubai, we have an office from this Sri Lanka Tea Board. It is a totally government authority. They have a separate office.
Good. I mean, other businesses should take, you know, note of these things and learn from these things.
Yes. So governments always try to help us as much as possible. But of course, the exporters also do their own part in promoting their own brands. But whenever it's possible, the government helps us too, yes.
No, it's very nice to meet you. Thanks for coming over. And you said you have been here many times.
Yeah.
But maybe we didn't pass by those areas. It was our
It was a pleasure. Thank you. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Thank you for all the knowledge of the tea.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. I'll think about you whenever I sip a cup of tea. Okay?
Yes, we'll do.
Thank you.